Okay, so you guys now know that the Supreme Court has announced its decision in Windsor versus the United States. And we won everything we asked and hoped for. Wow. I'm honored and humbled and overjoyed to be here today to represent not only the thousands of Americans whose lives have been adversely impacted by the Defense of Marriage Act, but those whose hopes and dreams have been constricted by the same discriminatory law. Over the past 2.5 years, many people have asked me, why did you decide to sue the United States of America over a tax bill? Because the answer is complex, I want to give you some of the background. I lived with and loved the Aspire for more than 4 decades, in love and joy, in sickness and in health, until death did us part. When Thea died in 2009 from a heart condition, 2 years after we were finally married, I was that in the woman I had loved was not a stranger with no relationship to me. DOMA, I was $1,000 in federal estate tax that I would not have had to pay if I had been married to a man named Theo. Even if I had met Theo just immediately before, married him, and never even lived with him before he died, the tax would have been zero. So overwhelmed with a sense of injustice and unfairness, I decided to bring the lawsuit against the government to get my money back. I lucked out when Robbie Kaplan, a litigation partner at Paul Weiss, walked into my life. Paul Weiss has a proud tradition of representing clients, including LGBT clients, in a wide variety of pro bono matters. One of those outstanding pro bono cases is Edith Windsor, that's me, versus the United States of America. At a time when the gay organizations that I approach responded with, it's the wrong time for the movement, Robbie Kaplan said, as did Martin Luther King before her, there is no wrong time to seek justice, answered my plea and took me on. And this old lady flourished with the help of the large and superb Paul Weiss team handling my case. Along with James Essex of the ACLU, who joined us right up front, and Pamela Carlin of the Stanford Law School Supreme Court Litigation Clinic, Robbie won historic convicting the Obama constitutionality of DOMA. 2, persuading the district court, Judge Barbara Jones, that there was no rational basis for DOMA and that it was unconstitutional. 3, we won the first decision ever by a federal appellate court holding that laws like DOMA that discriminate against gay people should no longer be presumed to be constitutional and should be subject to heightened judicial scrutiny. And monumentally, Robbie Kaplan, our counsel of record, argued our case in the Supreme Court. When she argued against DOMA, she was cool and calm and informed and reasoned, all of which was sustained by her deeply felt passion for equality in all of our lives. And we won all the way. So thank you from the bottom of my heart, Robbie Kaplan and your partners at Paul Weiss, for making this all possible. Thank you, James, for coming in and helping so strongly. I also owe special thanks to all the people in our movement who have worked as hard over so many years to achieve this result, especially Mary Bonotto, who led the effort on the briefs from our friends and allies in our case. And to the justices of the Supreme Court, thank you for affirming the principle of equal justice under the law. Finally, to all of the gay people and their supporters who have cheered me on, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, I'm sure Thea is thanking you too. Not only does a much larger portion of our straight members of our country see us differently, okay, as just people who live and love and bring up kids who will play with their kids, but our own community has come out and seen each other and loved each other in a way that makes me courageous and proud and joyous every day. Because of today's Supreme Court ruling, the federal government can no longer discriminate against the marriages of gay and lesbian Americans. children born today will grow up in a world without DOMA. And those same children who happen to be gay will be free to love and get married, as Thea and I did, but with the same federal benefits, protections, and dignity as everyone else. If I had to survive Thea, what a glorious way to do it. And she would be so pleased. Thank you all.
What was your very first reaction?
I cried. I cried. Okay, but I'm thrilled, obviously. But yeah, the immediate reaction was just tears.
Edie, it was a 5-4 vote.
If Thea were here, or I don't know if you believe in the afterlife, but what do you think she's thinking right now?
Thea.
Yeah, what is she thinking now?
You did it, honey. Okay.
Ms. Windsor, you can probably answer this better than anyone in America right now. What is...
Well, love is a million things, depending if we're talking about adult love or love of kids or what have you. What was love with me and Thea started with incredible respect for each other. And two mantras. Mine was don't postpone joy, and Thea's was keep it hot. Okay. Of course, love is much more than that, and it's like the word marriage. Okay? It's magical, and hard to. I hadn't thought about it. I thought this. There's a hunk of a poem by Auden. So now I'm going to use the word still instead. So still I have the answer from the face that never will go back into a book, but asks for all my life. No such. Yes.
You've been described by many as a hero. How have the last few years been working on this case and fighting this case?
Joyous, just joyous. Okay, I have found both in the gay community and certainly with my legal help. Unbelievably close relationships. It has been joyful all the way. And yes, there were insults, interspersed. And it's like they just fell off. Okay?
When you hear yourself compared to...
Guys, I'm deaf. I need one voice.
When you hear yourself compared to Rosa Parks or Louisa Brown or Harvey Milk, what do you think of yourself in that context? Rosa Parks, Harvey Milk?
It makes me feel incredibly proud. Okay? Incredibly proud and humble. Okay. Wow, do I deserve this? I think some accident of history put me here. Just proud. Very proud.
Were you optimistic about the outcome?
One at a time.
She will not be able to hear unless there's one question at a time.
Were you optimistic about the outcomes going into today's decision?
Going into the... Now, when we were... Oh, I prepared... as a possibility. I wished, no question, I did not allow myself to assume we'd win. Okay, that's the truth.
I thought
we had every right to win. I thought our arguments were sound and everyone else's were insane. Okay,
It was a 5-4 ruling.
Yes.
So can you speak to that statistic?
No, but maybe you guys. Certainly Kennedy, and that is one of the things that gave me hope. Kennedy has voted on the side of gay equality twice before in very significant suits. And I hoped that he would this one as well. That's all I know to say about it, but some of these guys know the history better than I do.
Edie, can you tell us
about your evolution from a closeted lesbian into a hero of the movement,
yeah,
and
yeah.
what made you not only come out of the closet.
Okay, so incredible to me. I know that as long I worked for IBM for 16 years originally, and then for another three later. And I lied all the time. And I worked in a kind of faster group. We had a floor in the Time Life building. Okay, we were not situated with any other groups because we were brand new to the company. Okay, and we were very close to each other. And I lied all the time. So that indeed, when our marriage, when our marriage announcement was in the New York Times, okay, people, you know, I lied. Okay, Edie, you know, we were close. And homophobia is a bitch. Okay, And I had some of it, okay? We all had some of it, in our way.
Okay, two more questions.
Yeah. Look, it's hot in this room for me, and I'm younger than Edie. So literally two more questions, because it's
here
too
and
hot.
Here.
Okay. I wanted to find something, if I have it. At some point way back, somebody asked, what do you think would happen if you win? And sadly, I don't have it in here. But what I talked about was the beginning of the end of stigma, okay, of lying about who we are, it's a different level of dignity than we've had, and that our kids have, and that the generation coming along doesn't really think it's all a bunch of baloney and unnecessary. They don't believe the discrimination. But my whole generation, has a new moving thing. Do I think ultimately, I think it's the end of suicides. I think it's the end of teenagers falling in love and not knowing that there's a future for them, with love.
One more question.
When you started all of this, you said that people told you it's not the right.
Right, you have to try it slow, baby. I'm sorry. I am so dumb.
I'm sorry. When you started all of this, you said that people told you it wasn't the right time for the movement. It wasn't the right time to
right.
attack this.
Okay.
Particular thing. Did you think that it would go all the way to the Supreme Court? Did you think that it would have such a lasting effect on the nation?
Once we started to work together, I thought anything was possible. It's true. We had an incredible relationship. Okay. Robbie describes it as we took turns being mother, taking care of the other one. But I really saw it as, from the beginning, we both thought we had the smartest people we had met. Okay, and so we had enormous confidence in each other, and then we added this smart guy, and then another smart person.
Edith, what's next? Are you going to keep embracing this role and bring gay marriage to every state of the country?
Probably not. I think there's a whole world of people who will do that. Okay, will they find me a willing help if they need it? Absolutely. But no, that's certainly not going to be central in my life. Central in my life is going to be the risk. I don't have a ton of years left, and I would like to relax a little bit. Okay, to have it.
One lawyer
okay.
question, that's it.
Yeah.
What does this mean in terms of other couples like Edie? Can they now, do they have to go to the courts to try and get money back that they
do
had to pay?
Oh, no. Okay.
Taxes?
Yeah, I need a lawyer to answer that.
Open up. Yeah, is this retroactive for other couples?
Okay.
Yeah, first of all, going forward, Section 3 of DOMA is dead. So people who are married, gay and lesbian couples who are married, now have full marriages entitled to equal respect under both state and federal law. In terms of other couples, that is going to depend, in terms of other couples who are married now, that's going to depend on each federal program and benefit. There's rules about how many years you can go back and get taxes back. There's rules about estate tax, et cetera, that will apply based on each program. Everyone who's brought a case, and there are a lot of people out there who brought cases, will get their relief, and will get DOMA will be gone for them. Edie will get every cent of her money back with interest.
Yay! Okay, thank you guys.
All right, I need you guys to clear a path right now.
Let's get her out. Let's clear a path.